dynamics to create a gas stream with known water content. So right here, we have a table detailing the mass fraction of the water as well as the hygrometer reading. So let's say, for instance, that the hygrometer reads 43, and we have a given of mass flow rate of stock gas of 1,200 kilograms per hour. Now, utilizing what's been given to us as well as engineering problem solving skills, we'll have to find the mass flow rate of the water vapor in the gas.
All right, hey guys, I'm gonna be explaining the diagram that we have. So right here in this top system, we have air going through this whole system to this point right here. Although in the problem, it doesn't show that there's a box right here, this box is the mixing point of when air and water meet to create the gas. And so these rotameters just measure mass flow rate, and the evaporator and the dryer don't actually process anything. All it does is just change the air into dry air and the water. It just changes both into a gas state so they can mix. And so whenever they're mixed right here, we get the stock gas rate of 1,200 kilograms per hour right here, and then this gives us the reading of particles 43.
So we're going to be talking about our knowns, unknowns, and assumptions. So from the problem, we're actually given the hygrometer reading R equals 43, and we're given the mass flow rate of the stock gas, which is equal to 1,200 kilograms per hour. And from that, we have some unknowns in the problem that we need to address. So we're asked to find the mass flow rate of water vapor, and that's one of our unknowns, and that's basically what we need to find right here. And we also have the unknown of mass fraction of water, which isn't given in our table, which should correlate to the hygrometer reading of 43. So in order to solve this, we need to be able to assume that whatever comes into the system must come out of the system.
So the goal here today is trying to determine what the mass fraction of the water is at R is equal to 43. Now, in order to do that, we're going to go ahead and enter into the Excel the values of the hygrometer reading, which would be R, as the X values, and the Y values as the mass fraction of water. We're going to select these values and enter them into a scatter plot on a graph in order to be able to determine what the trend line is. Now we're going to add in a trend line, a linear trend line specifically, in order to determine what the equation is to find the value of y at x is equal to 43. So you're quite literally just going to add in a linear line, linear trend line. So what we end up getting is y is equal to 0.0021 times the hygrometer reading plus 0.0005 is equal to the mass fraction of water. Now, all we have to do is enter in the hygrometer reading of 43 to determine the mass fraction of water at the hygrometer reading of 43.
Okay, so after obtaining the line of best fit, which is 0.0021 R plus 0.005, we can find what the mass fraction of water is when R equals 43 by plugging in 43 for R. And we find that the mass fraction of water at R equals 43 is 0.0908. And so now we can proceed to the next step, which is that mass fraction of water equals water over the mass of water over the mass of the gas, the total mass. So this is why we have x and 1200 plus x, because x is the mass of the water, which we do not know, and 1200 plus x is the total mass of the air plus the water. So then to solve for x algebraically, we multiply over 1200 plus x to that side to get 108.96 plus 0.0908x equals x, and move all the x's to one side, so 0.9092x equals 108.96, and then divide by 0.9092 to find x, which is 119.84 kilograms per hour of water vapor. And turns out this is our answer.
So now we're on to the real world examples.
Now, first we're gonna start off with obviously dry cleaning because you know that's the whole point of the video. So what we're gonna talk about is the fact that dry cleaning actually uses a version of this information by determining the quality and quantity and the type of chemicals used while dry cleaning. Next example would be soil sterilization, you know, life on Mars, yeah. So that information could also be used to determine how long we need to boil the soil in order to make it sterilized for the Martian potatoes. And then, of course, ironing clothes, because, you know, Iron Man is boss. So we're going to use that exact formula, actually, to determine the optimal humidification of the air in order to properly iron your clothes.
All right, so we're going to wrap it up here, and we're just going to reiterate on what we did in our project and what we learned. So first, what we did in the self-paced module to solve ChemPro problem A is we used the information from the problem to find the regression line so that we can find the mass fraction of water at R=43. And we did that in Excel. After that, we used the mass fraction of water found from the formula we derived from the regression line to find the mass flow rate of the water vapor as Anik showed in the previous part. And so overall, what we learned from this project, self-paced project, is that we learned how to work better in a team, and we also learned how to become more self-sufficient and learn more about the problem solving process. And be sure to like, comment, and subscribe to my video. We hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.